And we're going to start. This presentation is Trick Plays and Unbalanced Formations. Now, one of the reasons why I kind of developed this is because at the Glacier Clinics I was speaking, and I got a lot of questions about some of the plays that we were running on some of the cut-ups I had. And then I sat down with our staff, and we went over the last couple of years and started to look at what plays were very successful for us. And then we realized that a lot of our big plays were actually some of our trick plays. So we said, you know what, we got to start coming up with a formula to where we can use more of these. And the first thing that we said, and one of the best things that I think that we did, is we said for every single game that we have, we're going to either have one trick play or unbalanced formation per half. Now it's either or. So we can have one game with two trick plays or one game with two unbalanced formations instead, or one and one. You know, a trick play in the first half and an unbalanced formation in the second half. So that was kind of a format that we used to make sure that we were staying in line with that. And not last year, but the year before, it actually ended up being very successful for us, and it definitely changed our season. Our kids were our average athletes that year, and we actually ended up having a really good year because we were beating some of the teams that, you know, we probably shouldn't have off of some of these big plays. So these are some of the plays that I put together that I wanted to share. And one of the things I wanted to talk about was that everything you see on here tonight, it's not all done in 1 year. So don't think that we do all this in 1 year, because that's definitely not the case. But we do definitely try to mix it up a lot, and you'll see a lot of that. Okay, so the first slide, the positives. The positive is about trick plays. First, is there fun? I think for us, our kids really bought in. They've had a lot of fun doing them. Every time we come out on a Monday practice, first thing they ask us, Coach, what are our trick plays this week, or what formation are we going to run? And that's something that we've had fun with, they've had fun with, and if they're having fun, I truly believe that they buy into it more. So that's something that we've made a session during our offensive day. It's an offensive session, it's a scoring session, but we definitely mix our trick plays in there, and I'll explain that more a little later on. The second thing that's a positive is it makes teams prepare and practice more. Now, we just had our seeding meeting for our schedule for next year, and one of the reasons why I put this comment in here is because there's one team at that seeding meeting, as they were walking out, they said, oh, thank God we don't have to play Harbor Fields, because we can't figure out what the hell they're doing. And, you know, that was one game where we ran a bunch of different stuff against them, because we knew they ran a lot of man coverage and they were all over the place. They weren't very defensively sound. They blitzed a lot, so we were able to take advantage of that with some of our formations and trick plays. And it was definitely a big win for us. They came in 6-0 at the time, and their heads were spinning by the end of the game. So that was kind of a compliment to us that they were thankful that they didn't have to play us this year. Another coach had mentioned, and they're the top team in our league, they do formation recognition every Monday. After their Monday practice, they sit out there for about, you know, half an hour to 45 minutes to go through every formation of the team that they're playing. And he said, the thing I don't like about you guys is when we play you, our formation recognition period is about 2 hours. And again, if they have to practice more against us, we find that to be successful, because now they're thinking, and when they think, they stink. All right, that's our philosophy. But with that being said, we want to try to run our trick plays and our formations with a lot of our base schemes. So if we have to change too much of what we do for a certain formation or a play, we're not going to run it. And you'll see that later on in the slides. And I'll explain, hopefully without confusing you, how we do that. The third thing is it confuses defenses. I think that's really important. Like I said, if you can get their head spinning, and they're thinking, they're definitely not moving as fast as they can be. And just by a formation change, if they don't know who's eligible or who's not eligible, or how many extra gaps we added to one side of the ball, and they don't know where to line up, they're definitely thinking, and we're taking advantage of that. The fourth thing, it definitely can be a game changer, especially if you start stalling down the red zone and you steal a quick touchdown. Or, you know, it's a defensive battle, and all of a sudden you pull out a trick play to spark it up. it could change the game. It can change the momentum of the game. You can get the crowd back into the game. And like I said, if your kids are having fun, you're executing these things, that's, you know, definitely a success. The fifth one I really like, hopefully some of you guys know who Gus Malzahn is. He was the offensive coordinator at Auburn, and then was the head coach at Arkansas State. He's back at Auburn now. But anyway, he runs a lot of trick plays and unbalanced formations. And when I saw him speak in an interview, the first thing they asked him was, why do you do that? Why do you run trick plays and formations? He said, the number one reason I do it is because it keeps the defense in zone coverage. I know what coverage they're going to stay in. And he truly felt that when he coached, and he was a high school coach for a very long time, he felt that when he had, when he didn't run those trick plays or unbalanced formations, and they went man-to-man coverage with his guys, sometimes their guys were better than his guys. So he had to do certain things to take them out of man coverage. And he started doing some trick plays and unbalanced formations so that they had to stay in their zone coverage. Another guy that's kind of like that is Urban Meyer. Now, everybody thinks Urban Meyer is, you know, the guru of the spread, and he is. But I've seen him talk at a clinic, and the first thing he said is, even though he's the guru of the spread, he doesn't like going 2x2 sets, where you got two receivers to the left and two receivers to the right. He doesn't like being too balanced, because he thinks when you're balanced, the defense is balanced, and if the defense is balanced, you don't know what they're going to do.